The Killisberg district in the north of Stuttgart. The Brückner family lives on a hill overlooking the city in a house that's always flooded with light.
Hallo, herzlich
welcome. Please come in.
Schirin Frangul Brückner is an architect and designed the house herself. She usually designs trade fair halls and exhibition rooms, so she's used to creating sleek and sophisticated environments.
In our office, our philosophy is that form follows content, and that's a principle we wanted to apply to this house as well. It's about conveying a certain lifestyle and creating an open space for the family in which we feel comfortable.
The house has 270 square meters of living space spread across four stories. The top floor doubles as a kitchen and dining room. With windows like these, there's no need for a balcony.
These are sliding doors that allow us to open up the entire facade.
With its panoramic view across Stuttgart, the house certainly feels very open. But special blinds ensure that no one can actually see into the house.
I'm interested in the way architecture can be fluid, the way a house can change its mood in the course of a day and feel somehow different.
The living room is on the second floor, complete with cupboards that act as space dividers and provide ample storage space.
These are fitted plexiglass closets, which are illuminated from behind. They provide very unusual lighting, especially at night.
The Brückner's two daughters share the floor below. Despite its functional and open-plan appearance, the house has its fair share of playful elements, cozy nooks and crannies, and modern art. The children's floor leads out into the garden.
The garden is a mix of Mediterranean and regional plants. There's a fig tree, a palm tree, and a wild vine we found when we bought the land.
The ground floor contains a guest room and the main bedroom. Like everywhere in the house, the dominant materials are concrete, steel, and wood, relieved by an occasional splash of color. The family has been living here for 6 years, and they're now hatching plans for their next project.
I'm going to be in charge of the next house. My wife and I have agreed on that. I'm thinking of something that feels like it's in constant flux as it's used and as the seasons change. A house where you can tell from its atmosphere how many people live there.
But the family won't be moving house anytime soon. When you already live in the perfect home, you're not likely to be in a hurry to leave it for another one.